Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 722, filling quarters and years. Hey, welcome back. It's time for another Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. We've done this one before, but Mary today sent in a better way to go. The fill handle, of course. The fill handle, when you're using the fill handle with quarters, it's smart enough that after quarter four, it starts over again at quarter one. And this is so flexible. There are so many different ways that you can do this, like spelling out quarter, using QTR, just using Q1. All of those work. My favorite one, this is cool, even first quarter, they get it. But when you try first, second, third, fourth, but when you try and do quarters and years, like Q1 2013, you see that doesn't work. They're just repeating Q1 over and over and over again and extending the year. But what I can never remember is the correct way to do this. Well, Mary sent in a few more examples. I've done this on the podcast once before, but Mary's ideas are 1Q-13 will properly extend. We go 2, 3, 4, and then it goes back to 1Q, but goes to the next year. She noted that the period also works. So 4Q, then it goes to 1Q, 2Q, 3Q, and then I tried it with a 4-digit year, that works, and then also leaving out the dash, but using the 1Q. It's kind of funny that they make us use 1Q because, you know, while Q1 works just fine for quarters, 1Q does not work at all. If you do 1Q, they don't know what to do at all. So it's kind of funny that the 1Q nomenclature is the one that works with the years. Really confusing. That's probably why I can never remember this. Well, we have a little bit more time today, so while we're here, a couple more tricks. Here we have the 15th and the last of the month. Maybe like, you know, if you're in payroll and you pay on the 15th and the last of the month, I'm going to right-click and drag and say that I want to fill months, and it correctly gets the 15th every single time, but then gets us the last of the month. So the 31st, then June 30th, July 31st, August 31st, even out here in February, goes to the 28th. So cool trick there. Another thing with the fill handle, any word followed by a number will automatically extend the number. So just like room 101, you can extend. And now a couple more. If we want to do Roman numerals, now this is not the fill handle doing this. This is a formula. We're using equal Roman of the row 1:1. We'll extend those Roman numerals. Or if we want to do letters, we use the same trick, equal CHAR of the row of 65. The character 65 is the capital letter A, so that will let us fill the letters. And there you go, some cool fill handle tricks. But thanks to Mary for sending in these variations of how to fill quarters and years. You're going to have to write that one on a sticky note if it's something you have to do, because it really, to me, is not intuitive at all. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.